Okay, welcome back everybody. Today we are going to go over how to do displacement modeling inside ZBrush. And as you can see in the video here, basically took very simple shapes, very organic shapes, such as like the ship here, the ring, another ship. Also did a human model here, cut it up, and generated displacements on it to get some very unique shapes out of it. Whereas you can see stuff is going in and out due to the displacements, adding a very sci-fi feel to it, just using one texture and one displacement map to generate that effect. And we're going to do that inside ZBrush today. Real quickly, let me show you kind of what we're going to go over today. We're going to do a background building, say like in a futuristic city. This particular one here, I did same concept, pulled out a basic shape out of a Dynamesh, and then displaced it with one texture. And then same thing with this one here. And that's what we're going to be working on today, creating this very cool shapes out of real simple geometry. And then at the end of this, I will show you how to take it into Element 3D, which is a After Effects plugin. And then I will show you how to create this glow effect inside Element 3D. So for now, let me close him down. And we will go inside ZBrush. And real quickly, I'll have in the description below 7 different displacement maps plus textures for you. And my own configuration inside ZBrush, so I'm not going in and out of menus here. And you'll see that, so you can follow along pretty easily. So now let's go into ZBrush. Alrighty. So today we're just going to go into our tool panel. Sphere 3D. We're going to make Polymesh 3D so we can edit it. We're going to draw him on the canvas. T to edit it. Okay. We're going to turn the polyfill on. As you can see, it's still the same geometry as the Sphere 3D. Go into your Dynamesh inside your geometry palette. Turn project off, keep it at the 128, and then Dynamesh. Now you can see it's already projected it for us there. We can turn the polyfill off for now. And real quick, we're going to make the base of the structure, the protruding legs, out. So activate your symmetry by tapping X. And I've got a little UI down here for it, so radial symmetry. Activate Y, turn off X. And we're just going to give him 3 legs here. So 3 into the radial count, enter. Going to size him up. Pretty much about the size of the sphere itself. Scale him down a little bit. Click on your snake hook. And then let's drag. Kind of twist him out a bit. You'll see the geometry is getting a little stretched out there. Not a problem. Just control. Draw a mask. Now it's retopologized it using the Dynamesh. You can go in, you can smooth it out a little bit. Okay. Now snap him, align him to the center there. Still got symmetry on. Pull and drag him up. Okay. Let's go ahead and turn symmetry off now. We don't need him anymore. We're going to just go to move. I'm going to scale him all the way up here. And then we're going to kind of drag and offset him just a little bit. Got a little stretching of the polygons again. Just Dynamesh him again. Smooth them out. Go to each side. Make sure we don't have any stretched out polygons there. Just do a quick inflate. Control Z that. Make sure when you're doing inflate, don't have your draw size all the way up, or it, for some reason, it affects the whole model. I don't know if that's a little bug. I'm not sure. So, we're just getting some very unique shapes in here. You know, it doesn't have to be perfect. So, go back to the move. Stretch him out just a little bit more. Okay. Now, we can move those legs down a little bit. Oh, turn your symmetry back on if you want to move those legs. Kind of move and flatten them out a little bit. Smooth it out. And we want a nice flat base here. So let's go ahead and do your clip curve. You can turn your symmetry off there. Just snap him to the center. And then control and shift. Hold your, keep your shift down there. And if you need to move it, just hold your space bar. Okay. And go ahead and do mask real quick. Control and then drag out your mask. Nice. And let's see. Let's turn our polyfill on here. And I want to do a slice curve. We're going to create some unique geometry here. Or we're gonna kind of slice them up a little bit. So control. And it doesn't have to be perfect. I just want to create some additional poly groups here. That's what all is all I'm really doing. And give the top here one more. Now under your Dynamesh, click on groups. And you can do a polish. And then control drag. Okay. You can turn the polyfill back off. Now we got couple different meshes in here now because it separated them. Okay, I think we're about done with Dynamesh. We can turn him off. Right now we're at 218,000 points and we want to get him back down to a manageable size. Go into your Z remesher, keep groups, just keep it at the default adaptive 5 for the polygon count, and then Z remesh. Give it a few seconds to generate that. Okay, it's brought it back down to about 14,000 points. Didn't actually go hit the target that we wanted, and that's because of the adaptive. When you have the adaptive on, it does its best to get to 5,000, but it doesn't always get there. So we can turn the fill on there. As you can see, we still maintained our groups, which is great. Let's go ahead and do a quick polish. Not much, just a little bit here. And that'll kind of soften up. It'll round over those corners a little bit for us. Okay. And we may do, go back into the Z remesher. We'll do half, see if that helps us get those points down. All right. So turn, it only dropped it like 1,000 points, so turn half off and you just drag him down. Just trying to get it to a manageable level. We don't need super dense geometry for this technique. I like to try to keep it around 5,000. That's just personal preference, because when we get all the way up, we're going to be working in, you know, about 10 million polygons. So we want to keep it at a manageable level. So, go to your deformation, you can do a polish by feature, usually just a regular polish works great. Don't do it too much, especially on a low poly count like this. You'll end up just shrinking your whole thing if you did like a polish 100 on it right now. So, alrighty, so now we've got our low poly to play with here. Go into UV map now. Here's where we start having fun with the displacement. Change it to 4096, drop it to UV map border 0. And I like to use UV planner. It's just personal preference. I like the results of it. So we can get rid of our polyfill. Open up a texture map. And you can use any one of the texture maps that I supplied. I think I'm going to go with number 4. And we'll see what we come up with. I mean, as you can already see, it's added some neat textures all over it. But the fun part is always when you start tiling it. So we'll do a 2 repeat on the H, and then we'll just do a 2 on there. See how that looks, maybe 3. May drop the H down to 1. Let's go 2. Okay. You know, you don't have to get excessive. You can do as many tiles as you want. It's entirely up to you. But I kind of like the larger forms that it's going to generate, especially here and these kind of panels right here. These are going to generate some really neat topology for us here. So now, on this little UI down here, this is all in your geometry tab here. I just copied it over. Click Smooth UV. And then under Displacement, let's load up our actual displacement, which is it'll be a BPR depth, number 4. And then turn your mode on. Crank up your intensity until we see something that's kind of neat. Okay, we'll stick with that for the moment. And right now we're at a low poly right now, so the displacement is kind of funky. So we're going to divide a couple times and see what we come up with. So we can change the intensity. We'll go to 0.4. See what that looks like. Now, as you can see down here on these little tips down here, the thing with displacements, they push in and out, okay, depending on the gray level. And you can adjust that with this mid slider here. If you drag it down, it does more of just a push out. Or if you go beyond 0.5, it'll shrink him in, and you get more of that effect there. So we'll drop him down. Alrighty, we're getting some interesting shapes here. But before we ever do a displacement, we have to do a little trick. We have to trick ZBrush into thinking that the tiles is a 1-to-1. Because it will not displace at that 1-to-2 setting that we have right here. So what you have to do real fast is we have to export this geometry. Lower this guy all the way down. And before you ever export, go into the export here and make sure that the offset and scale have not been adjusted. I always keep the scale at 1. Sometimes I don't know what causes it. I know Unify and the deformation will cause that. It'll cause the scale and everything to adjust inside your export panel. We don't want any adjustments, so make sure the scale's at 1 and then it's 0, 0, 0. And now we export, and I'm going to call the, just save it as export. That's what I do. I already have one in here, so I'm going to save that. Okay, now all you have to do is report it back in. Grab export. Okay, now our deformation has kind of changed a little bit, and that's because it's still set up as a 1-to-2. But if we reset it to a 1-to-1, okay, we're back to where we were. See, now ZBrush thinks this is the tile is a 1-to-1 now, even though it's actually 1-to-2. Very cool little trick. All right, so now we can bring subdivisions back up. And we can turn off displacement real fast. And we can do some slight tweaking of the model if we like. So make sure you click this quick 3D edit, which is in your transform palette. And symmetry, that radial symmetry is still in effect. So we can actually go out here and let me lower the resolution down a little bit. We can scale them up just a little bit. kind of get rid of some of that pushing and pulling of that geometry there. And it kind of looks like, it's interesting. Let me see. Let me turn the texture map off. Ah, I see. I see where all that extra junk's coming from. Alright. Nope. We don't want to select rectangle. Ah, okay. We got a bunch of garbage geometry in here. That was due to the Dynamesh as well as ZRemesh there. So all we got to do is delete it. Delete hidden. Okay, everything should be back to normal. Turn the texture back on. Everything should work just fine. Alright. Yeah, definitely before you ever apply displacement, do your little export trick there. Make sure you got clean topology, you don't have any stray polygons around. I think I still got a little bit here, but I'm not going to worry about it for now. Alright, so bring him back up to the subdivision 4. We're going to divide him up. We're only at 235,000 points. We're going to divide a few more times here. We're almost at 1,000,000. Alright, we're at 3.75 million right now. And which will probably displace halfway decently, so we're going to give it a try. We may not have enough topology, but we're going to try it and see how it looks. I usually try not to go over 10,000 or 10 million polygons. So it seems to have displaced halfway decently. I'm going to turn quick back on, turn the polyfill off, and now we have a nicely displaced model. And if we wanted, we can even move some of those cuts that we have, because those cuts still exist. We can go to Move Topology, and we're going to drag him up a little bit, back down. All right. Now, with the Move Topology brush, it's only going to move, it will only move the whole model, because we've technically got like three or four models in here. It's only going to move that whole island and nothing else. So you can go in and tweak this all you want. Adjust the shapes all you need to, stretch them out a little bit. Okay, so we ain't gonna tweak them too much here. Go under deformation there, and we can do a quick polish by features. And if you notice right there, that's due to the moving. It'll do that to you. So you can go in and you can try to smooth him out a little bit. Careful not to hit those edges. Alright, so just polish by features again. When you do polish by features, it's going to kind of soften the corners a little bit. It also puts like an extra little crease into it. So get it all smoothed out. Smooth them out just a little bit. Not looking for perfection here. Alrighty, so now what we're going to do is we're going to decimate him down. Because right now we're at 3 million. Or almost 4 million points right now. We want to get him to where he's manageable inside other applications. And today we're going to do Element 3D. So, and it's not going to be happy if I send him that big of a mesh right now. So what you need to do is open up your Z plugin, Decimation Master. Make sure that Keep UV is on. and then pre-process current. And give it a few minutes, and then we'll be ready to start decimating. So let me pause this, and I'll come back, okay? Okay, we are back. Alright, now it's already done all the pre-processing. Took like a minute, 2 minutes there to process. Go into, just kind of drag him a little bit in the polys here. And we're just going to shoot for 200,000 polygons. So 200, enter. Okay, and it does all the percent of decimation. It'll figure all that out for me. And then click decimate current. Takes a few seconds, and it's done. It's figured it all out for me. As you can see, there's not much of a change. If we do polyfill now, now you can see, now we're full of triangles and, yeah. But it's held on to all our UVs, which is a great deal for us here. Awesome. I'm happy with that. Don't really want to do much more moving or tweaking with this at this point. Really, I designed this more for background assets, like if you want to make a futuristic city or alien outpost in the desert or something like that. I mean, the possibilities are endless with this technique. So we're going to take our 200,000 poly mesh here. I'm just going to go under back to our tool and quickly rename him. Rename him. I'll just do tutorial. Okay. So this way we can find the maps and everything when we go into After Effects. Now, with the decimation and all that, I mean, while you still have that panel open, you can adjust the size. You know, if you wanted to make a, you know, a 500,000 polygon, you could do that. You can adjust that. You can make multiple versions here. So, you know, you're not limited to just doing, you know, 200,000 polygons. You can make, a higher res version. But this particular model, when we export him out, you know, he's only going to be probably about 12.5 megabytes. So we'll save him out. It'll save out a bitmap from our texture, which we're going to be able to use. So let me see what happens when I hover over this. 12 megabytes. That's great. I mean, you can make a bunch of these assets like I have in the past week. I just made a bunch of them just practicing this, and you know, the possibility is endless. You can create a futuristic city. It's just great what you can do with this. So now we're going to go out of Photoshop, and we're going to go into Element 3D, and I'll show you how to set all that up in there. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, here we are back in After Effects. I've got the CC 2014, so I've got the Creative Cloud version. Alright, so we need to make a new composition. And I just got it at 720p at 24 frames, 1 minute long. Okay, got him opened up there. Quickly, let's make a new solid. And we're going to call it E3D for Element 3D. Create a new camera. I just use 35, whatever preference you got. Okay. Now let us open up. We need to bring our textures back in. So File. And let's see, where was I? There's our tutorial bitmap right there. Import him in, and we need to make him into a composition, so drag him into there. Okay, and then Control D to duplicate him, and let's name each one here. I'm going to name one Glow, and then name the other one Texture. so we know which one's which. Okay. And in the glow one here, double click him. Zoom out here. Add, we just need to add two effects, or actually just one, I think. No, two effects. Go under channel and to invert. Alright. And then quickly under color correction, go down to tint. And change the white. We'll just go to, we'll make a red. Okay, so we're going to end up with a red glow here. We can close him out. You can close your texture out. Get your projects here. Drag and drop your glow in here. And then drag and drop your texture. And you can turn the visibility off. Now we can go to our E3D layer. Go to Effect, Video Copilot, Element. Give it a second here. Okay. Under your custom layers, go to custom texture maps, click glow, and then assign layer 2 to texture. Now let's go to our scene setup, and now we can bring our model that we just created over into After Effects. Click on import, and tutorial. Okay, everything's good. Physical shader we want. Auto normals, good. Click OK. And when it comes in itty bitty. I don't know why, it just does. Quick way to fix that, click this normalize size. There we go. There is our model without the textures on it. I'm going to turn the grid off. Show ambient. Okay, close that. Now, open up your tutorial folder there. We're going to change the default material. Click on diffuse. And just click those first four on there. Diffuse, glossiness, reflectivity, illumination. Under diffuse, load your texture. Click on texture. There we go. It's already applied the UV map to it. The coordinates are perfect. See, under glossiness, we'll load that texture again. I haven't quite found a perfect method on the glossiness and reflectivity just yet, so okay, this way the shadows don't have gloss to them. We'll do the same thing with the reflectivity. Everything's super reflective in here. Now, in your illumination, load your glow channel. Okay. Now, we want to crush this one to where it's just those highlighted, or in this case, it's actually the shadowed areas. All we're doing is just right in the crevices there. And tweak it to where we don't get any of the panels showing up. You have to crush it way down. Just play with these sliders until you get it to work. You can even adjust the white. All right, we're going to go with that and see how that looks. Let me zoom in a little bit here so we can see what we're doing. Okay. It looks pretty good, and it works very well inside Element 3D. Let's go real quick. Let's change our environment. I'm going to your basic 2K here. Just click on it. There we go. Just so we can add some extra light to the situation here. You can change your reflectivity a little bit. Obviously, you are going to want to tweak the reflections and the glossiness and all that. So, but I'm not really going over that today with you. What you're really interested in is the illumination. Now that we have the illumination in there, let's turn it on. And there you go. Now all our little crevices are emitting light. Alright, so we got our basic scene set up here. Let's click OK. Alright, now it's loaded up outside here. To quickly go into your camera controls, just start hitting C. It'll cycle through them. So hit C one more time. You get this little gizmo here, and you can actually rotate the camera around. Okay, hit C again. This one's your pan. C again. Now you got your zoom. Alrighty. So that glow is just not quite popping yet for us. So we're going to change a couple settings in here. We'll go down to your output. Not output. Render settings. Change your ambient. Enable it. Give it a little more shadows. Give it a little more contrast. Go down to glow. We're going to activate that. Enable glow. And it's automatically set up for illumination. We can change the intensity down just a little bit so it's not overpowering. Obviously, there's no exact formula to this. Just a lot of playing with dials. That's basically how I do it. Real quickly, we can even add a light to the scene. Zoom out here. Layer, new, light. Point light's fine. We'll just 80% in the darkness so it doesn't go pure black. Click OK. Alright, the light's way over here. If you just hit V, you go back to your pointer and you can drag your light in 3D space. Cool. And real quick, go back to your E3D. Go under your shadows. Enable shadow mapping. And I like to use ray traced. And ray trace will slow it down a little bit. Go back to our light here. Now we can start seeing shadows projected across the model. If you have multiple models in here, it'll project it across all of them. Zoom back in, see what we're doing here. Pretty cool effect here, done relatively quickly in what, 30 minutes? It's not bad. So you can make a lot of these little assets here in a short amount of time. Like I said, these aren't the heaviest models in the world. You zoom in, you know, you start seeing, you know, artifacts from the decimation and all that, but that texture definitely helps sell it, especially from a distance. So you keep these little guys in the background here and add a super high-res model in the foreground, whatever, make a big animation, whatever you want to do. It's sky's the limit here, and it was super simple. Hope you guys enjoyed this. Definitely leave me some comments on here or on my ZBrush page there. I'd like to see your results, so let me know, okay? Thanks.